Right, Will. How y'all doing? You know what I'm saying? Old girl told me I need to get up and go to work. You know what I'm saying? Get up and go to work early today. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to get up and go to work early. You know, it's 8:24. And I'm talking to all the banks in the whole wide world. Especially my bank. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to be calling today. You know what I'm saying? To every bank in the world, you know what I'm saying? Today is my son's birthday. Happy birthday, Jerry, you know what I'm saying? That's my new Jerusalem. I'm Adam, you know what I'm saying? And my son is, I'm Israel, Jeremy is new Jerusalem, you know what I'm saying? That came down out of heaven. With God, from God, with God, you know what I'm saying? And then his seed became, that he planted, became Jesus. And Jesus was born in Jerusalem, remember? So it all fell right in place. Israel gave birth to Jerusalem. Liberation Day, you know what I'm saying? First day, we're out of that fiery hell of the body, of sin, the flesh, you know what I'm saying? I kind of liked it, you know what I'm saying? And I still like it because we still using it, but it's a glorified body now. I mean, it's glorified, meaning I accept y'all as being fellow gods, but being the same kind of God I am, not like no God of T.D. Jakes or Bill Winston or T.D. Jakes, Bill Winston or Creflo Dollar, you know what I'm saying? The preachers that think you gotta get money on Jesus' name and make him a beast and all that there kind of stuff, you know what I'm saying, and worshiping the devil and all that, you know what I'm saying, and wrongful thinking and wrongful teaching and all that. We ain't for that, you know what I'm saying, and to all the banks, you know what I'm saying, wherever I go, you know what I'm saying, car lot, wherever I go, I expect to be welcome today, you know what I'm saying, this the old man. God, you know what I'm saying? I ain't but 57. But to y'all 25 and 30 year olds, 57 is the elder, you know what I'm saying? So I am, you know, a sir or a sire or an ass, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I deserve with a Z to be sire. You know what I'm saying? And let me read my stuff. You know, she said go to work early. You know what I'm saying? I feel my godness and my God in. This letter is to all banks that belong to God. To the mercy, to the grace, to the forgiveness, to the charity. out of the life. Stop asking for $100 and little shit like that. Ask God for big shit. What I am, what am I? Am not. What am I? God, am not. You know what I'm saying? Ask yourself, what am I? God, am not. You know what I'm saying? What am I without? You know what I'm saying? Without God, I am. John 16:23-32. In that day, you shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say to you, whatsoever you shall ask the Father in my name, he will give it to you. That's ask. Here too, you ask nothing in my name. Ask and you shall receive, that your joy may be full. These things have I spoken to you in Proverbs, but the time cometh when I shall no more speak to you in Proverbs, but I shall show you plainly of the Father. You know what I'm saying? At that day you shall ask in my name, and I say not to you that I will pray to the Father for you. Why not, Dad? Why not? You know what I'm saying? For the Father himself, Adam, loves you because you have loved me. Have believed that I came out from God. I came forth from the Father, and I am coming to the world again. I leave the world, and I go to the Father. His disciples said to him, "Lo, now speak to us plainly. Speak no proverbs. Now, are we sure you know it's all that? Need it not that any man should ask you? By this we believe that you came forth from God. Do you now believe? This is it. Behold, the hour come, it is now come, that you shall be scattered. Every man to his own, and you shall leave me alone. Yet I am not alone, because the Father Adam is with me. These things have I spoken to you, that in me you might have peace. In the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Take heed to yourself, lest you forget the covenant of the Lord your God, which he made with you, and make you a graven image or a likeness of anything that the Lord your God hath forbidden you. For the Lord your God is a consuming fire, even a jealous God. When you shall beget children and children's children, and you shall have remained long in the land, and shall corrupt yourself and make a graven image or likeness of anything, and shall do evil in the sight of the dear God, to provoke him to anger, I call heaven and earth to witness against you this day, that you shall soon utterly perish from off the land, whereto you go over to the Jordan to possess you. You shall not prolong your days abode. You shall utterly be destroyed. The Lord your God shall scatter you among the nations. You shall be left few in number. Whither the Lord shall lead. And there you shall serve God, the work of men's hands, wood and stone, which neither see nor hear, nor eat nor smell. But from this you shall seek the Lord your God. You shall find him, and you shall seek him with all your heart, with all your soul. In tribulation, and all these things come upon you, even in the latter day. You turn to the Lord your God, and shall be obedient to his voice. For the Lord your God is a merciful God. He will not forsake you, neither destroy you, nor forget the covenant of your fathers, which he swore to them. For ask now of the days that are past, which were before you, since the day that God created man upon earth, and ask from one side of heaven to another, whether there have been any such thing as this great thing is, that God has become Adam, and Adam has become God, a man, a mighty angel, have been heard like. Did ever people hear the voice of God speaking out of the midst of the fire? As you have heard and lived, you know what I'm saying? And Adam is the consuming fire. Or have God essayed to go and take him a nation from the midst of another nation by temptations, by signs, and by wonders, and by war, and by mighty hand, and by stretched out arms, by great terrors, according to all that the Lord God did for you in Egypt before your eyes. Unto you it was shown that you mightest know the Lord. He is God. There is none else beside him. Out of heaven he made you to hear his voice, like I'm doing now, that he might instruct you. Upon the earth he showed you his great fire, showing you now. You heard his words out of the midst of the fire, because he loved your father. Therefore he chose their seed after them, and brought you out in his sight with his mighty power out of Egypt, to drive out nations before you, greater and mightier than you, to bring you and to give you their land, for it has, as it is today. Hold on. All right now. let y'all win all the time. And to bring you, to give you their land for an inheritance, as it is this day. Now therefore, this day, and consider it in your hearts, that the Lord, He is God in heaven above, and in the earth beneath, there is none else. You know what I'm saying? Thou shalt keep therefore His statute and His commandments, which I command you this day, that it may go well with you, and with your children after you, and that you may prolong your days upon the earth, which the Lord your God gives you forever. And this is to all the banks in the world. That was your letter. And here is your covenant, your new covenant. Let me find it. You know what I'm saying? I got a lot of stuff I've been doing. You know what I'm saying? For justice. For all y'all. You know what I'm saying? For God's children. You know what I'm saying? There's the bank. Already read you that one. Contract. Covenant. Covenant 1. Alright. From the beginning, the Lord has made covenants with His children on earth. When His people make covenants or promises with God, they know what He expects of them and what blessings they may expect from Him. They can better carry out His work on earth. The people who covenant with the Lord and with whom the Lord makes covenants are known as the Lord's covenant people. Within the Gospels, covenant means a sacred agreement or a mutual promise between God and a person or a group of people. In making a covenant, God promises a blessing for obedience to particular commandments. He sets the terms of His covenant. He reveals the terms to His prophets. If we choose to obey the terms of the covenant, we receive the promised blessings. If we choose not to obey, He withholds the blessing. See, God work like this. When you got mercy, grace, forgiveness, love, and charity, and all that good stuff, it reverses the curse of the enemy's jealousy and envy, and it makes him fall away from you. And envy and strife and all that war and all that evil can't come nigh you. He withholds the blessing, and in some instances, there's a penalty also that is given. We promise to take His name upon ourselves to remember Him, and not just to remember Him, but to actually be Him. To remember Him is to be Him. You know, to imitate Jesus is to allow yourself to leave yourself and be, you know, yourself. yourself as Jesus. You know what I'm saying? And when you come to God in prayer, you say, this Jesus, that's your son, you know what I'm saying? This your daughter, you know what I'm saying? Jazarian, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, you know what I'm saying? And to obey his commandments, we are promised that the Holy Spirit will be with us. God has also made special covenants with particular persons or groups. He made special covenants with Adam, Enoch, Noah, and the children of Israel. He made a special covenant with Abraham and his descendants that blesses members of the church and all nations of the earth today. Think about the covenants you have made with God and the blessings he has promised you for keeping these covenants. New Testament is Adam LaTroy Jackson's testimony of 2,023 years as Adam God, Christ, Pick, and Uncle Pick. My new name. This is the third covenant. Just as the first need a second. If the second had not been sabotaged and not obeyed and broken, a third covenant would not be needed. So we need a third covenant and a testament. And T.D. Jakes, you don't have to die if you already did. You already died. You don't have to die, but like you gotta die. This new covenant is about love, health, wealth, eternal life, the prosperity of God's soul, and the children of God's soul. God is love. You are Adam's. You are also God's. That make God's. By making love. Your health, Adam is your helper, your Holy Ghost, your wonderful counselor, Pop's ghost, ghost rider, I am your helper, everlasting father, your wealth, I am Adam God, while within in my rightful saying, godly, holy, heavenly mind, to bless Adam God, all of those that are Christ, since Adam God came with the shout, and we all got caught up in the cloud of God, Christ, Pig, and Uncle Pig. Divided $1,984 zillion, which is $23 million up front to every man, woman, and child living on Earth, plus $6,000 a week, which will only be added, multiplied, and divided, never to be subtracted. Eternal life. This is the Holy Ghost, God's Holy Spirit. This is the army of G-O-G, God of Gods. And M-A-G-O-G, which is Mighty Adam, God of Gods. Our Majesty, Adam, God of Gods. These armies gathered together in numbers of the sands of the sea, even of you, the number of the stars in heaven, protects this reward and inheritance from any evil or ungodly rejection of any gift. It is also a commandment that is given to all men, women, and children. It is God's law. It is also God's law and God's commandment that everything will be charged to heaven from now on. My covenant will I not break, nor will I alter what I have written, nor what have gone forth out of my mouth, lips, I have remembered my covenant forever, the word which I commanded for thousands of generations. I remember, it has come to my mind, the same covenant that I made with Abraham. Isaac, and Isaac confirmed the same to Jacob for a law, and to Israel for an everlasting covenant. This is the lot of your inheritance. Anyone denies, rejects, curses this covenant will receive a curse, and I have given you blessings and curses. Remember, I said, I will turn the heart of the father back to the children, and the heart of the children back to the father, lest I smite the earth with a curse. None of this document can be added to, overturned, rewrote, or altered in any way, at any time. This is an eternal covenant. Reward and inheritance from Adam, God, Christ, Little Pig, and Uncle Pig, and the rest of our gods. P.S. Check say if any banks refuse, deny, abuse, misuse, or mishandle these funds in any ungodly or unholy or unheavenly way, that's all the money we need to run for president. I am the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, the Alpha and Omega, the first and the last, the Almighty. Thank you, Jesus, and all of all nations. Right now, you know what I'm saying? bank. Hey, just think of it like this, man. Just doing what you normally used to do all the time, but you don't have no limitations. Ain't nobody coming in there with bad credit. You don't care about their credit. You don't care about nothing, but they got their right driver's license. Now, me, you gonna have to excuse me today because I got my appointment coming up soon. And I'm not gonna miss my appointment, but I got an appointment to get my driver's license renewed. But then, as of now, they, you know, expired. So, I still got a license, you know what I'm saying? So just use that, you know what I'm saying? And use me as just be an exception for Adam, you know, for God, you know what I'm saying? But then, you know, everybody else, you know, we need to have the right ID, you know, good, you know, not expired, you know what I'm saying? That's not for everybody to get away with that. You know, I'm just pulling a little rank. And, you know, I just want everybody to know, man, that, you know, you got $23 million up front now. And you got $6,000 a week. And that grow and grow and grow and grow. It never, ever subtracts from. I never take from your money to pay for nothing. I always pay for everything with just y'all's driver's license. And y'all's, you know, government ID. You know, that's all, you know. Just to let you know it's registered to you. That's why when you buy stuff like earbuds, if you steal earbuds or something, they not gonna work because it's not gonna register to the computer that you paid for. You know what I'm saying? That's why it's not going to register to you when you try to hook them up. If you ever steal some earbuds or equipment that's got to be tapped into something, it's got to be, you know, having where it knows that you paid for it. A lot of people get mad and say, oh, you know, they can trace money and stuff like that. It's easy to trace money. And you need to trace money. Because a lot of people do stupid things with money. You know what I'm saying? So I don't put it, you know, I don't, you know, leave no stone unturned. I use all my senses. You know what I'm saying? And that's the covenant. You know what I'm saying? That's the new covenant. Y'all getting all that money. And it starts tomorrow. You know what I'm saying? Today for me. But then tomorrow for y'all. You know what I'm saying? So let's get on this, get this going. You know what I'm saying? Because I plan on getting me a truck today. You know what I'm saying? In the name of God. I plan on getting that truck today. You know what I'm saying? We'll get off.